Hey guys, Peter here to do an album review, and today I'm here to talk to you guys about the brand new album from Omnium Gatherum, The Burning Cold, out right now. This album has 11 songs, 52 minutes in length, and I had a really hard time dissecting this album and putting into words. I wrote some notes so I wouldn't forget anything, because this album completely sucker punched me and caught me by surprise. I was expecting a solid album from this band. I was expecting a good overall record from this band. I was not expecting the masterpiece that these guys released. Incredible album. Completely caught me off guard. I was like a deer caught in the headlights. I just didn't know how to feel, what was going on, like, what is this? Like, it completely caught me off guard. And this album has bulldozed its way. I mean, they've pushed over almost everybody, and they've made it to my top list of albums of the year. They're neck and neck for first place as far as favorite albums so far, and I want to highlight so far of 2018, because obviously the year's still young. There's still going to be a lot more albums coming out, so I want to make a bold statement by saying this is going to be the best album of 2018. But right now it is neck and neck for first place for me for best record so far of 2018. What an incredible album. I was not expecting this. It really caught me off guard. It really blew my mind. And it really made me sit down, listen to the album multiple times in order for me to just be able to gather my thoughts and be able to write some words so I could record this album review. This perhaps is one of the hardest album reviews that I've ever done, because the album and the music were so good. It connected with me in so many ways that I'm really having a hard time expressing into words how this album feels, at least to me, how I felt listening to it. I'm really having a difficult time expressing how I feel into words so I can describe to you guys what my views are on this record. That's how good and how mind-blowing this album was to me. Now, the album starts off with an intro track called The Burning. It has a great guitar melody, and then it leads in into the second song of the album, Gods Go First. I really like this intro track. Normally, I'm not a fan of intro tracks. I've said this millions of times. I don't really like intro tracks. This one, if there is a reason for an album to have an intro track, and if there's the perfect way of having that intro track, this album, this track, this is it. I love what they've done. Great guitar melody. It really sets the tone for the record. And by bleeding into the second song, it really extends the play of that second song. Makes Gods Go First a much bigger, more melodic, more heavier, more longer and extended song, and I like that. I really like what they did with this intro track. It really allows for the listener to really dip his toes, if you will, in the water before taking the plunge. That's how this intro track really feels, and that's how an intro track should really work. And this one works to perfection. I really like it. I like how it sounds. I like how it feels. I like how it connects to that second song of the album. I like the life that it gives to the album. And then a very interesting point is that the last song of the album has a little bit of that same riff from the intro as in the last song of the album. So what this creates, it creates a full loop. If you listen to this album on full, from song 1 to song 11, and then you loop it so that when it finishes song 11, it goes back to song 1, there is a feel of continuation. This album is built as a circle, if you will. The whole album is a circle. The way the album starts and the way the album ends, then the album ending bleeds into the album start. It's absolutely incredible. I love how they did that. It really allows for a listener to just really immerse himself into the music and completely get lost in it, because you stop understanding when a song ends and when an album starts, and everything just becomes a big cloud of smoke. It just becomes music. It just becomes art. It just becomes something that guides you, something that becomes who you are, and you're no longer concerned about song ending and song starting and what song of the album I'm in and how many minutes this album has. All of those things become irrelevant. They become secondary to the pleasure that will be your listening experience to this record. And I really like that. I really like how they did that, and that intro track plays a huge role into that. Now, like I said, this album really has music that allows you to be transported into different places. It's really an album that plays really well from that perspective. It really allows for you to just close your eyes and let the music be your guide. Let the music take you where it will. You don't need to force anything. You don't need to really overanalyze anything. You just really have to allow the music to pass through you. You're a vessel to this music. This album really works well from that perspective. It really transcends you, if you will. When you're listening to this record, you really feel like you're listening to something that is bigger than just music, that it's bigger than just a record. Each song really has a life. Each song really has a life of its own, and then when you put them all together in a record, the overall record has a heart. You can feel its palpitation. It has a heartbeat. This album really has a heartbeat. It has life in it. And that is what makes the album so great, is that the album has the individual dynamic of each song, but when you put them all together, it has a sense, it has a purpose, it has a start, it has a middle, and it has an end. While the end doesn't really give you an end, because the end then really merges into the new beginning. So almost like life and death, if you think about it, this album really is an overall, to me, it felt like an overall representation of life. Because you're born, you grow up, you get old, you die, and then if you believe in reincarnation or if you believe in life after death, there's just a new chapter that comes after. So life never really ends, it just transforms itself. You just become a different kind of energy. And this album to me really felt like that. It just really felt that it never ended. The songs never ended. The energy just got transferred to a new stage, to a new song. And that is what mesmerized me about the album. Obviously, this is only possible with great musicians, with great music. So obviously, this is done because the drumming is incredible. The keyboard melodies in this record are beautiful and yet melancholic and yet dark and ominous. The vibe that the keyboard melody gives the record is just gives it such a wide range of emotions is incredible. And they use it in different songs in a different way to give you that different emotion that they could get out of that keyboard melody. Just incredible. The guitars is insane. I mean, the guitar work on this album is, it's just incredible. Incredible melodies, incredible riffs, and incredible use of the guitars in the right spots at the right times. As far as solos are concerned, or as bridges are concerned, they really created songs that are masterfully put in place, where the solos come in at the perfect time and give just that extra punch that the song needs. They didn't go overboard with the solos, they didn't make solos that were too short. They really created songs that had an identity, that had a fingerprint, and that had its own trademark, while overall still belonging to this overall picture of what this record is all about. I also have to mention Yuka's vocals. Incredible. This guy has the perfect voice for this kind of a record. Because for a record that is this melodic, that has this much melody coming at you from different places, either be guitars or keyboards, you really need something that creates a little bit of a yin to the yang. You really need something that emphasizes that melody. So his harsh vocals are really the perfect spice that allows for the music to become even more melodic. Because when you have that contrast between the melody of the music and his harsh vocals, it really allows for that contrast to really showcase how extreme those two ends are, but at the same time, how well together they really work. So his voice, his vocal performance has to be mentioned, because to me, it's really what sets the rest of the music apart. The music itself perhaps would get lost if you didn't have that kind of a vocal performance to really compensate that melody by giving it some heaviness, by giving it some harshness. Now, as far as favorite songs are concerned, it was really hard to pick three songs. I mean, I could technically close my eyes, go with my finger through the track list. Any song that my finger stops at, it would be a top three song on this record. But if I have to really narrow down to three songs, I have to start with Gods Go First. First single of the album, second track on the album, first song on the album. Absolutely incredible. The great keyboard guitar combo of this song really gives a great mix of melody and heaviness. And that balance between the guitar and the keyboards and the songs is really what sets this album apart, in my opinion. The chorus is also a perfect example of how well that combo works. This song to me is really a roadmap to how a guitar should be played and how melodic and heavy melodic death metal song should sound like. This is a perfect example of melodic death metal, of how a guitar and a melodic death metal scene should really be used and should be used in this format. Incredible. And I really like how they merged that keyboard there. They didn't overuse the keyboard in the sense that the keyboard is predominant in the forefront. They used it there, it's there, but it's not the predominant sound. It's just a bass line. I absolutely love it. This song was such a great way to get me started with the listening experience of this album. It just opened the doors for what was to come next. And what was to come next, as far as favorite songs are concerned, I would say is Rest in Your Heart. Heavy and filled with melancholy. That's the best way to describe this song. The melancholy that comes from the keyboard melody adds such an interesting dynamic to this song. I love the heavy vocals to start off. They're not harsh. So the first set of vocals are heavy, they're dark, they're very ominous, almost like speaking vocals, if you will, before the harsh vocals kick in. I really like how they did that because it really set the tone for the song. This is a very dark and somber song, and when you start off with those dark kind of vocals, speaking vocals, if you will, instead of the harsh vocals right away, it really sets that tone. It sets the tone for a song that's gonna be very dark and somber, full of melancholy. And then when the harsh vocals kick in, that's when the heaviness of the song kicks in. But the overall vibe of this song, it's very melodic, but very filled with melancholy and darkness and despair. There's such a weird dynamic in this song, because while you have a lot of beautiful melodies in this song, those same melodies feel very dark and filled with despair. So there's a really weird balance that you have to deal with when listening to this song. And that to me is one of the things that attracted me about the song, was that dynamic between beauty of melody, but at the same time, darkness and despair that comes with that beauty. And that voice at the start, before the harsh vocals kick in, it's really the key factor that really sets the tone for that song and makes this song really work well. One of my favorite songs on the album. Now, my absolute favorite song of the album, this one was an easy picking because this was by far my favorite song on the album, and that's Be the Sky. I absolutely love this song. I'm really having a hard time putting words into sentences to describe this song. The guitar riff of this song is a thing of beauty. And I think if I said that this is my favorite song of the album, and the guitar riff is a thing of beauty, to me, that should be a description. It should be a good enough description that I could just move on and finish this review. Because this song speaks for itself. The guitar riff speaks for itself. The beauty of that guitar riff, I honestly think it makes doves cry. That's how beautiful the guitar riff in this song is. The dynamic of the guitar riff with Yuka's vocals, the combination of the two, are just incredible. This is a song that is just so melodic, so beautiful. There's so many things coming at you. It's just mesmerizing. It's just, honestly, this song is one of those that when I was listening to the album and this song came on, I had to stop everything that I was doing. And I almost couldn't believe my ears. I couldn't believe, it was almost putting me into a trance. That's how beautiful this song is. This is how well constructed this song is, that I really felt that I was being put into a trance with this song. One more thing I have to say about this song is the solo. I really like that they put the solo towards the end of the song. It really allows for a perfect closure of the song. I like that. I like that they saved it for towards the bitter end of the song. They give you that solo. They give you a beautiful solo that really continues in line with the rest of the melody of the song. And then the song is over. So it really gives a sense of closure, a sense of ending, a sense of coming to an end of the road as far as this song is concerned. To me, this is my favorite song of the album. I don't know, personally, I really connected to it. I connected to the beauty of the song. I connected to the beauty of the lyrics. I connected to how the lyrics and the song came together. That solo was absolutely incredible. This song is my favorite song on the record, a song that I will be playing continuously because the emotions that I felt when I first heard it, I can never describe those. The best way I can describe it is that I was mesmerized by it and I was just stunned. I just didn't know what to say and what to do at that time. This is a song that really caught me off guard, one that has found a very special place in my heart. This is it. This is the brand new album from Omnium Gatherum, The Burning Cold. I want to hear from you guys. Is this one of your favorite albums of 2018? What did you guys think of this album? What are your favorite songs? What are your overall thoughts on the record? Let me know in the comment section below. I'll be checking those out and getting back to you guys. See ya.